Okay, so we will start. Good afternoon, everyone. Hope you are doing well. Welcome to our webinar, which we will speak about the ministerial resolution number 883 regarding the system of equivalency of private schools American curriculum. Allow me to welcome you all. Royal American School is committed to every student's success. We believe that getting ready for the future starts from the first year in school. We work to ensure that our students can make the right decisions and have essential world-class skills that allow them to pursue their academic and professional goals. So let's get started. What we are going to cover in this session is, first, we will speak about the Ministry of Education system of equivalency of private school American curriculum, students streaming in our school, the subjects covered in both tracks, what are advanced placement courses, AP exams, and we will listen to your questions and inquiries. First, we will speak about the ministerial resolution number 883. You have to know that this resolution will be applied for the academic year 2022-2023. That means our students who are going to be in grade 10 next year, when they reach grade 12, this resolution will be applied for their certificate. So if they want to make an equivalency, or they want to get an equivalency from Ministry of Education, and they want their certificate to be generally track, they have to take the following subject: English language, math, science subjects including physics, social studies, or humanities. Now, if you want your certificate to be advanced track and get equivalency as an advanced track certificate, you have to take the following subject. First one is English language. After that, you have to take math, AP, calculus, AB, and you have to take science subjects. First one, physics, calculus based, and they give you the chance to choose between chemistry or biology as an AP level. So you can choose one of them to make an AP level exam on it. You can choose chemistry or biology to make an AB level exam. Okay, but for the math, again, for the math, it's not a choice. It is mandatory to take math AP, calculus AB. Okay, so you must take math AB and make an exam AP on math, calculus AP, and on chemistry or biology. You have to choose, you can choose between one of them. And also you have to take social studies or humanities. And they mention also in this resolution that the total hours shouldn't be less than 18. Okay, and they need also the transcript for grades 9, 10, 11, and 12. And you should pass all the subject from grade 9 to grade 12. You must pass all the subject and get minimum 60% or D. Okay, and also you have to make the MSAT exam. So these are the requirements from the Ministry of Education for the equivalency of grade 12 students. Okay, which will be applied on 2022-2023. Okay, upon this resolution, our school will make two tracks. The first one is general track and the second one is advanced track. So students who are going to be in grade 10 next year have to choose one of these tracks, okay? Starting from now, the students who are in grade 9, we'll choose between these two tracks. Now, what is the difference between these two tracks? For the general track, we have three categories, okay? The first category of subjects are mandatory subjects. It includes MOE subject. Wait a moment. So we will continue. As I told you that in general track, we will have the mandatory subjects, which are the MOE subjects that include Arabic and Islamic, English, Math, Biology, Chemistry, and Physics. And we have also humanity subjects. You can choose one of them. And we have elective subjects also. You can choose one of them. Now, for the advanced track. For the advanced track, there is a difference between the grades. In grade 10, we will start to give the students the basic information about the AP courses. Okay, so we'll start the basic information for the math subject, for the biology, physics, and chemistry. Excuse me. As I told you, in advanced track, for grade 10, the following subjects will be covered. We will take the MOE subjects, of course. They will be with you within all your grades. Okay, English, Arabic and Islamic. And you will have English also. You will take advanced math. As I told you, it is the basic for the math AP, which calculus AP, which you are going to take it in the next level, in grade 11 and in grade 12. And you have to take advanced biology, advanced physics, advanced chemistry, plus one humanity subject from the box I showed you before, and one elective subject. Now, in grade 11, you will start the AP courses, okay? You will get ready for these courses. So if you decided to do it, to do the exam on math, in chemistry or in biology, you are ready to do it in grade 12. Okay, you will be ready. The school will work to make it easy for you and get it ready, get you ready to make the exam in grade 12. Okay, now in grade 11, you will take the MOE subjects, English, Math AP, Calculus AP, Physics, Calculus based, Chemistry AP level or Biology AP level. So as we saw before in the resolution, the ministerial resolution, they give you the chance to choose between Chemistry AP level or Biology AP level. So also we here giving you the chance to choose between these two subjects. Okay, which one you want to make the AP exam on it, you can choose even Chemistry or Biology. And whatever your choice is, it will be the same in grade 12. It will continue with you in grade 12. Okay? Now, here we will speak about the advanced placement courses. First, you have to know that the advanced placement courses is an international exam under the authority of College Board. Okay, so if you need more details, now we will speak, of course, yani a little, we'll give you a little information about it. So if you want a deep information, you can go through their website. It is collegeboard.org. Okay. Now, AP courses are college level courses offered in high school. Mainly, it consists of 38 courses in 7 disciplines. But of course, as I told you before, you have to do only in math, AP level math, calculus AB, and you have to choose between chemistry or biology. Okay, so only these 3 subjects. The chemistry and biology, you can choose one of them, and the math is mandatory to do it as an AP level. Now, courses reflected what is taught in top introductory college courses. Students take AP exam at the end of the course, measuring their mastery of college level work. The AP exam is scored from 1 to 5, where 3 or higher is typically earn students college credit and or placement into advanced courses in college. So if you take 3, it will be enough to let you pass and enter the university requirement. Okay, now AP it is a very beneficial exam. And it also helps you even if it is not required from the Ministry of Education. Many students have do it before because it is really helping them in getting accepted through the college admission process. Okay, AP courses can be challenging, but it's work that pays off. Taking AP is valued in the college admission process. 85% of selective college and university report that a student's AP experience favorably impacts admission decision. AP teachers are among the most prepared, dedicated, and inspiring teachers in the school. Students develop confidence, learn the study habit, time management skills. Taking an AP course helps students build critical thinking skills, essential for success in college. Now, for the AP exam, AP exams are administered by schools worldwide on set dates in May each year. So in May, the exam will be held. Exam are typically 2 to 3 hours and include 2 types of question. The first one is multiple choice question. The second one is free response items such as essay, problem solving, document based question, and role response. Now, you have to know that each college and each university has its own policies regarding AP credit and placement. The College Board offer information about AP credit at thousands of college and university at their website. So if you want to search by the school name or alphabetically, the College Board give you this chance to know more information and details about the university requirement regarding the AP exams. Okay, data for each school includes a direct link to that school webpage detailing AP credit and placement policies. Now, there is some myths and realities about AP courses. AP courses are for students who always get good grades, and this is a myth. This is a false information. The real one is AP courses are for any students who are academically prepared and motivated to take college level courses. Another myth is AP courses are too stressful, and this is also not typically right, because yes, the AP courses are challenging, but the support you receive from your classmates and teacher can help you manage the workload. I don't think I will score high enough on the AP exam to get college credit. This is some of students thinking, But this is also wrong because you don't need to score a 5, as I told you. Many colleges grant credit and placement as well, but based on a 3 or higher on an AP exam. Taking AP courses could hurt my GPA. This is wrong because taking AP courses show college that you are willing to challenge yourself academically. Last, I can't take AP because no one has recommended me. The reality is, if you think you are ready to take an AP course, then you are ready to advocate yourself. Just talk to a teacher or a counselor. Now we reach to the end of this presentation. You can send your question on the chat box. Type. We will take the first question from Ahmed Tariq. Yes, Ahmed.
Yes. So there for the AP calculus, actually, there is AP calculus AB and AP calculus BC, right?
Yes.
So, I want to take the AP calculus BC in grade 11. Is that possible?
Actually, we chosen the AB. You speak about math, right? Math, calculus,
because AB. Maybe I even read about it. It's very easy. I saw all the examples.
Yeah, but
it's like really easy.
We want you to yani follow the ministerial resolution. So they mentioned that they want the AP, the AB, math, calculus, okay. AB. Okay. In order to get the equivalency, if you want your certificate to get equivalency from Ministry of Education in grade 12, as an advanced track, they want you to take the math, calculus, AP, AB, okay?
Okay, so is it possible to, for example, after that in grade 12, take the BC?
As an additional test for you, you want it, it's optional, ya Ahmed. If you want it, you can take it. But it's not required, it's not one of the requirements from the ministry, okay? From the ministry, they want the AB only.
And I can choose as many APs as I want, as long as they include the requirements, right?
Yes, Ahmed, you can choose. It is optional. It's up to you. If you want to take more than the subject they require, it's up to you, of course.
Okay.
We will get the question from Sharif. Yes, Sharif.
Teacher, does AP exams grant you extra classes or? You don't get extra classes, just no, you will get as anyone.
Okay, Miss Rasha will take this question.
Can you put your question again, please?
Does AP exam, the people who want to take AP exams will take extra classes?
We said for you in the beginning that we have two tracks, general track and advanced track. If you choose, inshallah, the AP, you will have special classes for that. You will not be with the general track. So it will not be extra classes. It will be your normal classes as your track. Okay.
Most welcome. Okay, now we will take Rashid. Rashid?
Yes.
You can unmute yourself. Yes.
So I want to ask, what is the MOE subject?
Again?
Subject, it's Islamic Arabic.
Oh, okay. Miss, and the AP and the AB, what are these?
AP subject we said for you is math is mandatory as the AP, and you should choose between chemistry and bio. According to physics, it will be calculus-based, not required to make AB exam for that.
Okay, Ms. Thank you.
Welcome. And also, yani, I just want to give you one advice. You should prepare yourself from now to think which college or which university you will go and try to ask the requirement of your university. what they ask you about, what the subject they want you.
Exactly.
Maybe you choose AP and your college that you will go or university doesn't need that. Maybe the other side, you choose general and your university needs the AP subject. So my advice for you as Ms. Rasha or Ms. Dima or all the teachers here, you should put your goal now and see university that you will go and try to check what the requirement of your university. Yes, okay, now we will take
Sharif. Sharif. We take it already.
Mohammed Mazen.
Yes, teacher. Miss, I have several questions. It might take a while. Is it fine?
No problem. Take.
How do I look for universities?
It's easy, Mohammed, to look for a university. First of all, you have to think where you want to study. Here, outside, you have to think now. Okay, and also you can make a list of your favorite university and your favorite majors you are interested in based on the subjects you are like it more. Okay, and after that you can search each university by its name. It's very easy to search yani the university and the requirements of each university. Everything is cleared in the site of each university. If you go and enter, you will yani find a lot of information about their majors, about their requirements, what exactly they want in the first year, what the paper they need, everything you will find in the your research.
That's Mahmoud, you should set your goal first. Set your goal, what you want to be, what do you want to complete your studying, in which university, in which major, like Ms. Dima said for you. After that, you can write about the universities that take this measure and search about it on the internet.
Yes.
You will find everything.
And also, if you need any assistance in that, I'm here, Mahmoud. First, set the list and I can assist you in any question you want or in any research you want, I can help you in that, okay?
Yes, and what does AP stands for?
Advanced placement. It is an advanced placement course. This course modeled on a comparable introductory college courses. Yani it is like a college level courses, okay? But it taken in the high school. It gets you ready for the university, yani even the university materials and the way of their exams. It is much alike between the college, the advanced placement and the university subjects and yani studying. Okay, it is like introductory for the college courses.
And sometimes this subject, if you take it from the high school, sometimes this subject cancelled from your university already. Yes. Because you took it before from high school.
Exactly.
Okay. They and also your certificate will written on it advanced if you want to go any international university outside in a German or America or like that. They also require for AP courses. Sometimes they give you 1 year for the like introduction for your university because you didn't cover this subject. But if you cover it in high school, you will not need for that.
Yeah.
And the next year,
from the courses from the university can be deducted if you have an AP courses in the high school.
Okay, and next year when we take the exams, would there be a special class or it will be the normal everyday school life, just like we are doing right now?
No, next year. Now you are in grade 10 or 11, yeah, Mahmoud?
No, I'm talking about next year when I become grade 11. The AP exams, how are we going to take it? Are we going to attend normal classes or it will be a special class for exams?
No, the type of exam will be added to you as a rehearsal exam test, okay? So that you can be ready to do the AP level exams in grade 12. It's not required from you in grade 11. It will be in grade 12, okay? The college board exam for the AP courses, it will be in grade 12, not grade 11. But the teacher will introduce you to the way of their testing.
Okay. And next year, will it be on site or online?
Inshallah, the structure of the school will share it with you, but until now, inshallah, we hope all the students will return to the school next year. And yeah, and really, really, to study inside the school, it will be different at all, inshallah.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome. Yasin?
Yes, ma'am. Is it a must to take this exam?
I told you, it's according to your choice. What you will choose? You will choose general or advanced?
Yeah, exactly.
As you set your goal, you will choose your track. According to your track, you will and that will be decided.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Muhammad Fikri?
What are the optional elective and humanity subjects that we can pick from?
I will send you the PowerPoint, Muhammad, okay? I will send you the PowerPoint and you can check the humanity subject and the elective subjects.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, you are welcome. Yasin? Okay. Muhammad finished. Now, Rashid?
Yes, miss, I have a question.
Yes, Rashid.
Miss, can I choose both chemistry and biology subjects or only one of them?
No, you will take both. You will take biology and chemistry, but you can choose one of them in AP level. Okay, so one of them will be on AP level and you make the test on one of them as an AP level in grade 12. Okay,
Miss, choose the chemistry or choose biology, one of them in the AP
level
exam. What if I choose, for example, if I choose the chemistry?
Yeah.
What's the, if I choose chemistry or biology in the future?
Yeah. Actually, in all cases, you are taking the three science subjects. So, if you are asking regarding the university requirement, right?
Yes.
Yes. Since you are taking the three subjects, so it is okay. And for the medicine major, they ask you to take the three subjects. Now I search all the university here inside UAE. They didn't change until now the requirements. We don't know, maybe the next year they will start to add some requirements for the AP levels in science subjects. We don't know. But until now, they no specific information about which one is favorably for the medicine to make an chemistry AP level or biology AP level. But my advice, if you want to go for medicine, for example, you have to do more focusing on biology subject. Okay, so if you want to go medicine, it's better to take a AP level in biology. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, thank you. Miss, can you send this PDF for us, please?
Yeah, yeah. I will send you the PowerPoint for this session. Okay, no worries.
Thank you.
Now, Sami.
Yes, my question is, will the exams of the AP classes will be from outside or made by the teachers?
No, AP courses, it will be on the... Like said, like set one, set two, it will be courses outside, not from the school. The exam will not be from the school, but the teachers will train you about the kinds of the different questions that we will have in the AP system. And I think Ms. Lamia with us on the meeting, and she can reply for this question more than me, how she will train you, Ms. Lamia.
But Sami, the international test or the AP level test, it will be in grade 12, not in grade 11. Okay, in grade 11 you will take the normal testing, but the teacher will start to introduce you how are the exams in AP level. Okay, so you will get used for these exams.
Yeah, and the teacher will prepare you from next year how to start or to answer these kinds of questions for AP.
Okay.
Okay, now we will take the question from Aisha. Yes, Aisha?
Yeah, Miss, I want to know, for example, if somebody wants to go in a medical school, so it's very obvious for them to study biology, like AP biology, but not AP physics. And like most of the universities don't require you to take physics. So is it possible, like if I'm taking the advanced course, and to replace physics with chemistry and take AP chemistry rather than physics?
No, Aisha. Physics is a mandatory subject, but it's not required to make AP exam in physics, okay? As you saw before in the resolution, the ministerial resolution, they mentioned that it's a must to take physics calculus-based, okay? As a normal subject, no need to make an exam on it, an international exam from the college board, I mean. So on grade 12, you don't have to do a physics calculus-based AP level exam. Okay, but you have to take this as a course, as a subject inside the school.
So like I can take physics as a course, yes. And it will be like added to my certificate that I took it as a course, but it's not necessary, yes, for me to take the exam for it.
Exactly, the AP exam, okay? But inside the school, of course, there will be exam for it. But I mean in grade 12, if you want your certificate to be in advanced track and you want to get the equivalency from the Ministry of Education as an advanced track, it is required for two AP level exams. The first one is math AP calculus AB. This is the first one. And the second one, they give you the chance to choose between chemistry or biology. You can go for chemistry AP level or biology AP level. Okay.
And here we go. And Miss, is it also possible, like, if you can do, rather than taking the AP courses, just do the SAT in grade 12 for SAT biology and SAT chemistry?
Actually, Aisha, let Miss Rasha answer for this question because she is the coordinator of SAT.
Yeah, according to SAT, what we heard until now, SAT harassment are not required for the in continuous years, inshallah. For the future years, they only require for AP or ACT. Said, I heard the IND will cancel it from next year, inshallah. But we don't know if that's true or false. But they said AP and the ACT will be accepted only.
Yes.
Okay, we have here Ms. Lamia. Yes, Ms. Lamia.
You can unmute yourself, Ms. Lamia.
Yes, good afternoon, everyone. Regarding the question, regarding the question that the student, one of the students, he asked, first of all, your exams will be, it's an external exam, but of course, in the school, for the subjects, you are going to get trained on the questions, like past papers, on the type of questions that you will have in your examination in grade 12.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you, Ms. Dima, I'm sorry to interrupt, yes, but is it not possible at all to take the exams in grade 11? I just have another question.
No, it's up to you, Ya Ahmed. You can take it in grade 11, but it's in your responsibility, okay? Because yani, the school put a plan to all the students to be ready to make the exam in grade 12, okay?
And already we add our course audit for grade 12.
Yes,
that you will help the exam in grade 12. At least we can prepare you for the new kinds of these questions. You are not prepared until now.
Yes, but if you want to make it in your responsibility, Ahmed, okay?
Okay, and just
for me, I don't advise you to do it early. Don't rush.
You have a chance.
Don't rush, Ahmed. You still have time.
One more thing. There is in the Ministry of Education, there are actually three tracks: general, advanced, and elite. Is that possible, yes, to like equivalency for the elite track?
Yeah, I want to tell you, our school only will go on two track: advanced and
general.
Yes. But already, like we told you, we'll teach you, inshallah, advanced for all subjects, even for science, for physics, we will teach you, inshallah, the basic calculus base. That's mean you will be, the material will be with you, but if you want to take the exams for AP as an elite track, you will take it also on your responsibility. We don't have this track in our school, but you can do it by yourself if you want.
Yes. Maybe later, yeah, Ahmed, after a while, we will open elite. We don't know. But for the coming year, we will have only advanced and general tracks. Okay. Now let me take the question from Muhammad Alaeddin. Muhammad? Yes, Muhammad?
Yes, I'd like to ask about the SAT exam, what was attended this year by grade 11. It's a council or what?
Ah, you mean the SAT, they did it already?
Yes.
In which grade now?
Grade 11.
Now you are in grade 11?
Yes.
You mean about pre-SAT?
Yes. Not pre-SAT, SAT exam.
It is pretty now, grade 11.
Actually, we didn't get your question again, please.
I did this exam of SAT this May, 2 weeks ago.
Yes.
Exam for English and SAT 1, I think. English, yeah. And math.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
It comes for what?
No, it will come, yes. Actually, for the next year, the College Board itself will stop the SAT 2 exams. All the SAT 2 exams will be stop. No more SAT 2 exams, okay? But SAT 1 math and English, it is open until now. But the requirement for grade, the students who are going to be in grade 12 on 2023, are not required to have SAT. They want them to have AP level exams, okay, in math and on one of the two subjects I mentioned before. They are not asking anymore about SAT.
Okay.
And this is according to the ministerial resolution, not from us.
Okay. These two exams will be held during the year, yeah? During 12. Grade 12, yeah?
Yes. We said for you it will be on May in grade 12, inshallah. Ms. Dima, in the presentation, she mentioned the date. The AP exams will be in May.
But now you are grade 11?
Yes.
Yeah, it's not applied for the students who are the next year in grade 12.
We asked only the students.
Yeah, we asked for the students in grade 10 and 9.
Okay.
Because the resolution will be applied, as I mentioned before, it is applied on the academic year of 2022-2023. So it is applied for the students who will be in grade 10 next year and onward, okay? The grade 10, when they reach, and grade 11 also. When they reach grade 12, grade 10 next year, and grade 11, the year 2022, they need to get their certificate equivalency from the Ministry of Education upon the this ministerial resolution 883. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah. So, grade 12 next year are not included in this ministerial resolution, will not be applied on them. Grade 12 students next year will follow the old resolution, the old one, which they need SAT, okay, and IELTS and MSAT.
That means the meeting only here for the students who will be grade 9 and grade 10. The students who will be grade 11, sorry, who will be
10 and 11.
No need to attend here.
Yes. It is only for grade 9 now, and the next year they will be grade 10, and for grade 11 who are going, 10, sorry, who will be in grade 11 next year. Okay? Grade 12 next year will be normally on the old resolution, not the new one.
Okay.
Nasser, this is the last question. We will take it from Nasser. Yes, Nasser.
Hello, teacher.
Hi.
What is the best and the most people is take it, the general or advanced?
We said before, it's according to your goal. What do you want to be? What do you want to... How you want to continue your life, the university will go. I can't choose for you. We can advise you. You can bring for us the university you want to go, and we can advise you which track you should go.
But in all cases, Ya Nasser, if you go in a advanced track, you will be able to get the chance in more majority. Okay, yani you will be open to admit to too many majors, because the one who goes advanced track can go مثلا for the general tracks courses, okay, while vice versa, no, the one who go for the general can't, maybe according to the university, can't study medicine because he didn't get the courses needed for the medicine in high school. Okay. It is dependent on the university itself, because some university they don't want the AP at all. Some university they ask for it. So, but my advice, if you are good in the science subjects, go in advanced track.
Thank you, teacher.
طيب هناخد عمر مين محمد محمد علاء الدين he already asked I think يلا محمد محمد
محمد علاء الدين
you want to ask or طيب we will take عمر عمر أيمن
teacher if we take the AB do we need to do the MSAT and the IELTS
MSAT is mandatory for all general track and advanced track.
Yes.
What about the IELTS?
IELTS, we said IELTS and SAT.
They didn't mention.
They didn't mention SAT or IELTS at all.
Yeah, as you have seen on the PowerPoint, they didn't mention anything about IELTS. Only they want the AP level courses and the MSAT.
Okay, thank you.
You are welcome. Type okay. So, Nasser, you want to ask?
No, teacher, thank you.
Alas, okay. So, any more question?
Okay, so to summarize what you said in this presentation, basically, if you take the advanced track, you are you have better chances, and you will get on your equivalency. They will write advanced, right?
Yeah,
they want
exactly
in the mark. Yes, the GPA is out of 4 for general courses, but out of 5 for AP courses, right?
Exactly.
And the total will be out of 4. And then there will be AP courses and exams for us to take. We have to do math and then one of biology or chemistry.
Yes.
And others.
Yeah.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure that I understood everything.
Yeah, you understand.
And thank you. You summarize for all your friends now what we want to say. Thank you too much.
Thank you all for attending. We hope that we get you clear in this ministerial resolution, and we ask you to choose and decide which track you want to follow next year. We will send you a Google form, okay? And I want every one of you to choose which track, yani before tomorrow, okay? And in all cases, you have I want you to know that you have 2 weeks in the next year, okay? If you choose, for example, the advanced tracks and you find that the subjects are too hard for you, you have 2 weeks to change from the advanced track to the general tracks, okay? And vice versa. You have 2 weeks to change between them. Only 2 weeks. Okay. Yeah. Thank you all and have a nice day. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Dima. Thank you, Ms. Rasha.
Thank you, Ms. Lamia, for attending. Thank you.
Thank you.
The SAT one won't be discontinued, right?
Sorry, Ahmad?
SAT one, we can still do it, and it will still be helpful for university, right, or not?
I didn't get you.
What? He wants to send for him the university list.
The university list?
No. SAT one. Is it still required or
They didn't mention anything about SAT or IELTS. They said now MSAT became mandatory. Before, they give you chance to choose between SAT and IELTS and MSAT. But now they force all of you to have MSAT.
Yes, exactly.
No SAT, no IELTS.
Okay.
But of course, if they change their mind, we will let you know.
And of course, if you want to take it as extra course for you, it's not bad for you. It's nice for your requirements when you apply for any university.
And in the UK, so it's better to take them
as well. Sure. Yeah. If you have a chance to do it, it's very nice.
Teacher.
Yes, Mahmoud.
Can you share the PowerPoint?
Yeah, exactly. I will send it in the groups, okay?
Okay.
Hussein,
teacher, I might be overthinking, but I still don't know how to look for universities. Am I supposed to Google this, look for several websites, or?
Yeah, Mahmoud, we can talk on this later, okay? Mahmoud, please send me on WhatsApp. What do you want exactly? Send me on WhatsApp. I will help you, no problem. You are welcome. Bye. Yeah, have a nice day, all of you. Thank you for attending. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.